Hello friends, my name is Gali Sarish. You are watching this video on my YouTube channel Financial Planner. Today we are going to see if you have money and if you are planning to invest, so where exactly you can plan your investments. This is where our entire topic would be covered. So the best investments at this point of time. So if you have money and if you are not utilizing that money most probably for next 45 days, then you can utilize liquid funds. And there is one latest regulation which has come up in liquid funds. If you withdraw your money within 7 days, then you would face a exit load on liquid funds. So any time between 7 to 45 days, you can always use liquid funds. And what is the rate of interest I'm getting in liquid funds? It's near about 5 to 5.25%. And it may vary to 5.5 also. And the second category, fixed deposits. Anytime between 45 days to 365 days, you can always plan fixed deposits. The rate of interest, yeah, it's varying between 5.75 to it's near about 6.75. So normally it is 6.5, 6.75. Maybe few of the private sector banks, they are providing us this particular rate of interest. Postal deposits are very well because they are paying more than 7% interest on our deposits, provided if you are holding your investments from 1 year to 5 years. So your time horizon, if it is more than 1 year and less than 5 years, you can very well choose postal deposits. I am not considering the tax angle in this particular thing. So if you add tax, definitely debt funds and hybrid funds are more beneficial as per taxation is concerned, and you would get approximately 7% on debt funds. And if you are investing in hybrid funds, then your rate of interest or expected returns would increase to 8% and 8% to 9.5-10%. It depends upon which kind of hybrid funds you are choosing. There are different types of hybrid funds. You can choose in any of those kind of hybrid funds. You can expect those kind of YTMs or yields on your investments when you are investing between 2 to 5 years. So what about my investments more than 5 years? Then this is where you have to bring your equity exposure, or this is precisely for people who are open to equity investments. So if people are not comfortable in equity investments, then you should stop there in 4 only. You have to choose between the first 4. If you are willing to invest in equity, then you can very well start with large cap funds, index funds and ETFs. For ETFs specifically, you need a demat account. Without a demat account, you cannot purchase ETFs. So this is entirely all the three categories which have been specified here. They would be investing primarily in the top 100 companies based on the market capitalization. So even in ETFs, I am considering only the Nifty and Nifty Next 50, those kind of categories, because within ETFs there are various sectoral funds are also which are part of ETFs. So if you are investing in this kind of funds, then your time horizon should be between 5 to 7 years. And one more thing, I would suggest not you to invest in a lump sum. Try to avoid as much as possible when you are investing lump sum, because there are some volatility can be expected in your short term, and based on that, if you invest your lump sum money today, then maybe in 15 days time, 20-25 days time, your investment may come down, so that would not be appreciated. So to avoid, definitely lump sum is not a right option at this point of time. And the best thing is, if you want to take interest investment, if you are wanting to invest in a slightly higher risk, then definitely this is the best place to be. Start your SIPs and STPs in small caps, mid caps and multi cap category, because this is the time where you should enter into this kind of category of funds. And it depends upon what kind of, because within small cap there is different ways of creating a portfolio within a mid cap, and that goes with multi cap or focused fund. Because when you are choosing a particular fund, then the portfolio has to be understood, and based on your risk profiling you have to choose your schemes. So why small cap, mid cap? Because for the past 2 years we have been seeing these two particular categories are underperforming. So I would not be saying underperforming, to put it in a more clarity, both these funds are giving me negative returns. So if I'm investing 1 lakh rupee, if I had invested 1 lakh rupee in the year 2018, January 2018, so I would have lost my investment. So my investment portfolio would be somewhere around 65-70 thousand. So this is what has happened in small cap and mid caps. But why I am suggesting small cap, mid cap and multi cap? Definitely there is a valid reason, and if you are thinking that I need to time the market, then this can be a slight hint for you to time your investments. So looking into this is a mid cap category. So if you have invested in January 2018, so for the entire 1 year you have made 12% negative returns. When I consider 2019, then man, so I'm still getting negative returns, but you can see there is a drastic improvement in the rate of returns. And in the past 5 months you can see there is a 4-5% average returns in different 3 months, and you have got one negative return month, that was in December 2019. So there is a huge improvement in the positivity of returns in mid cap. If you go with the same thing in small cap, and for 2018 it gave me 24% negative return, and in 2019 it has given me 5.5% negative returns. But if I look into 5 months, how did small caps perform in the last 5 months, then here you can see it has never given you any negative returns for the past 5 months. So this is the time, entry time for you in small cap funds. But as I have suggested to you, you should avoid lump sum, plan with a SIP or STP. And definitely if you don't know what exactly STP is, definitely you can always consult me, and I would be helping you out how to design your portfolio, how to invest, and hopefully you have understood where you should be investing with your investment. Thank you for watching this video.